here. Welcome back to the Grafana Alloy for Beginners series. I'm Mischa, Jung, a staff developer advocate here at Grafana. Last time we set up our learning environment. Today we're diving into collecting, processing, and exporting infrastructure logs using Alloy. Before we begin, make sure you watch episodes 1-4 and set up your learning environment. That way you're all set to follow along. Afterwards, head over to the series repo. The link is in the video description. Scroll down to section 1, build a pipeline for infrastructure logs with Alloy. If you haven't already, start up the learning environment and open the config.alloy file. We went over how to do that in the last episode. Now each section begins with the starter code, followed by a task explaining what the configuration does and the information you'll need. Finally, there's a solution that you could expand to see the complete config. To keep this episode short and sweet, I'll walk you through the final config instead of typing it out. You can copy the starter code into your config.alloy, try building the config yourself, then check the solution to see if you nailed it. In section 1, we'll learn how to collect, process, and export infrastructure logs using Alloy. We'll be collecting logs from Alloy itself by using the logging block, add labels to the logs with a loki.relabel component, export the logs to Loki, the log database, using the loki.write component. On screen, you'll see my config.alloy file with the final pipeline for infrastructure logs. So let's break this down. By default, Alloy automatically generates its own logs. We'll use a logging block to customize how those logs are created, like setting the log format and log level. In our config, we set the format to log format, and we'll set the log level to debug, which means that we'll capture all logs, including debug level ones. You probably wouldn't do this in production since it can get noisy, but for this series, it helps us see logs flowing in real time. After that, we'll send the logs to the receiver of the loki.relabel.alloyLogs component, which we'll define next. Let's move on to loki.relabel. This component is most commonly used to filter log entries or to standardize the labels that get passed on to one or more downstream receivers. In our case, we'll be using the rule block to add the label group set to infrastructure, use another rule block to add another label called service set to Alloy. Just a heads up, these rules run in the order they're written, so pay attention to the sequence. Now, anytime we do something to our data, chances are we'll want to send it somewhere else afterward. In our case, that destination is loki.write.mythical component. To specify that, we'll use a 402 argument and send the relabeled logs to the receiver of the loki.write.mythical component. This component receives the process logs from the loki.relabel component, then export the logs to our locally running Loki database. We do that by using the endpoint block and setting the URL to the destination we want to send the data to. In the repo, we've included the URL for our local Loki instance, so just copy and paste it right here. All right, let's do a recap. In section 1, we use a logging block to configure Alloy's logging format and level. Then we use the loki.relabel component to add the group and service labels to incoming logs. Then we use the loki.write component to export logs to Loki. On my screen, we have the series repo. If you ever want to double check your work or see the finished version of a section, you can expand the solution and check your config. Let's scroll down to reloading the config section. Now, whenever we make changes to the Alloy config, we need to reload it. To do that, hit the reload endpoint either in your browser or using a tool like curl. We'll copy this command and open our terminal. Make sure you're in the project directory. Paste and run the curl command. If everything looks good, we'll see a config reloaded message confirming it worked. Now let's make sure everything's working as expected, that our logs are being collected, processed, and sent to Loki. The good news is our learning environment already includes a pre-configured Grafana dashboard, so we can easily visualize the logs stored in Loki. To get there, scroll down to the verification section of the repo, then click on the link to the dashboards. Once you get there, click on Section 1 Verification. Now, you'll see the logs coming in,
And if you expand one of the log lines, you'll see the labels that we've added to the logs called group set to infrastructure and service set to alloy. In this episode, we walk through how to collect, process, and export infrastructure logs with Alloy. In the next two episodes, we'll learn how to build pipelines for infrastructure metrics. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next episode.